Yo, what's up, my YouTubers? And welcome to my kitchen. My main little room where I do my YouTube videos, I've completely gutted it and I'm rebuilding it with a full hardware setup, after which we'll be able to do loads of really cool tutorials and videos on hardware, classic sound recording tutorials, hardware and door integration and all the rest. But in the meantime, all of the equipment is piled up around my tiny little central London flat, so I'm sort of stuck in the kitchen. But I got a bit of free time today, so let's have a look at this product. This is the latest product in the T-RackS range from IK Multimedia, and it's the Joe Chiccarelli vocal strip. Hey, forget about it. It's going to make you an offer for doing your vocals that you can't refuse.
You're lucky I got a man of gut in the oven, or I'd bash your face into a bolognese. That's two kinds of food.
No, I'm allowed to do the stereotypical Italian thing because I've got Italian family. So that's my get-out clause. So what is it? Well, Joe Chiccarelli, famous old producer over the years, has produced loads of heavyweights, but in a very diverse range of different styles. So Jack White to Elton John to Morrissey, etc. This single plugin imitates or emulates his preferred vocal chain, which is a very complex set of parallel routings and effects returns and other bits and bobs, which you could, if you had my kind of experience, set this up in a door, but it would be terribly time consuming. And then when it came to actually tweaking and sculpting your vocal sound, you'd have to have a whole load of plugins all open at the same time, strewn all over your computer window, as well as access to all of your auxiliary return and parallel channels and everything. It would be very, very time consuming and laborious to do it. But this plugin gives you a very, very complex routing of all of his vocal chain. In a single plugin, so you just slam that single plugin over a vocal channel or over a vocal group bus and bing bang bong, you've got instant vocal processing. And I'll make no bones about it, I'm a big fan of IK Multimedia products, but this they've really knocked it out of the park with this one. Very, very good plugin, and I can't think of any other plugin that really does what this does. And just to say, I'm going to come back and do further videos showing this on guitars, because although no one's ever talked about that I can think of, because guitars and vocals share the same key frequency areas, this should work really well on guitars. And I'm even going to do a little video where I try it on snare drums and things like that. But primarily it's designed for processing vocals. So what do you get? Well, the meat and potatoes of this are these three parallel compressors. They're parallel compressors. This is an old Uri 1176. This is a Fairchild 670. And this is a really old Universal Audio 176 valve limiting amplifier. Each of the three compressors has an output control, which, you know, gives you how much you're feeding that into the chain, that particular parallel compressor, and a mute button to knock it out if you don't want it, and you can mix and match as many of them or one of them as you like. But each of the compressors only has a single amount control, which is a macro of all possible available settings for that particular compressor model. So as you roll it on, for example, on the 1176, you're obviously like ramming more and more and more signal into the compressor and getting more and more compression, going further and further over threshold. But to my ears, it also sounds like you're increasing the release and the ratio. But we'll come to that. Okay. So that's the sort of the core of it, these three parallel comps. There's an input level, there's an output level. At the input, there's a very useful high pass. There's a de-esser with two different center frequencies, which works really well. Over here, there's what appears to be a three-band EQ, but it's a bit more complex than that. Then there are two reverbs, two delays, a mod section, which is essentially a chorus, but with no feedback. Very, very useful little addition, this. Very clever. And then on the output section, there's a dry wet control, so you can run this, you know, as much blended in with the dry signal as you want, or fully wet. And finally, there's a drive control with an amount and a color control, which allows you to get anything from the most subtle saturation to full blown distortion in any type of flavor you want. It's a very, very cleverly well thought out plugin. And the reverb and the echo section are like the EQ section. There's everything specifically tailored to work really well with vocals. Okay, so let's go through it, and I'll give you my thoughts as well as you can kind of think of it as a bit of a tutorial if you're new to this stuff. We've got to have something to play through it. I've got a load of material I could play you through it, stuff I've played on or mixed or mastered or all three or both or whatever over the last year by different bands. an artist, but it's all of it's been released on Spotify and Apple Music and all that. So I'm going to get a copyright flag whatever I play through this thing. So let's have some Freddie Mercury. This is the Bohemian Rhapsody multitrack, the actual multitrack. It's nothing's been mixed, no EQ, no effects, no, nothing. So there's the basic backing music there, and there's one of Freddie's possible vocal overdubs at this point. I'm using this because the vocal isn't, the backing music isn't too cluttered at this particular opening verse part of the song. You can really hear the vocal. Freddie has a really good vocal, and people are familiar with it. So let's do it with Freddie. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just reset, which sets it very vanilla. It's really not doing much at all, but I'm just going to put this to full wet and then lower the output a bit. If I just drop it in and out with the power button, you'll hear that as I drop it in, it just hasn't, you can hear it working. It's subtle, but it just lifts the vocal out a bit. Here we go.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun.
Yeah, no, so in its vanilla state where it's really doing not much, you drop it in and it just lifts the vocal out. And that's mostly due to a slight presence boost and a little bit of this mod and a smidge of echo, which we'll come to. So, okay, let me sort of get into it. So let me start by showing, let's mute these three parallel comps, turn the high pass right off, turn the DS off, turn the air down, turn the body down, put this to post, no echo. There's no reverb, no modulation, no drive or anything. And we're just going to focus on this first compressor, this first parallel comp, which is, it's an old Uri 1176. Now, as I said, when you roll this on, it's a macro of all possible controls for 1176. The 1176 is a very fast compressor. To my ears, it sounds like as you roll this on, it's not only just piling on more compression, but it's increasing the ratio and particularly increasing the release. So it holds on, it clings on the longer, the more you pile on the compression. Now, this compressor, I will call this the slurp. It gives you all the sucking on the consonantal edges and the transient attacks of all the words, more than the others do, okay? So one thing you can do with this straight out of the box is if you pile on the presence, this presence control is sort of like a not too vicious bump at around 1 to 2.5, 2.7k, somewhere around there. You can switch the entire EQ section pre-post, but regardless of which it's in, when you boost the presence band, it's always boosting into the output of this 1176. Okay. So what you can do is you can really boost that presence area and start to hammer it with the 1176, and you get that classic 60s into the early to mid 70s, very presence pronounced, a slurping, which also emphasizes the air sounds vocal edge. Okay, now I'm massively exaggerating it by piling on the boost and cutting the body in air completely, but you'll hear what I mean. Here we go.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun.
So that gets you that instant, very present vocal presence in that upper mid area before it transitions into the start of treble territory, which is where all the emphasis of words, the sound of the lips, the sound of the teeth, the sound of the mouth, and the airy breathing type artifacts all live. And it emphasizes all that. Now, if you overcook that effect, you're getting that classic sort of much more mid-range vocal kind of edge sound with that slurping snatch to it, more sort of retro style 60s into the early mid 70s. But if we just roll that back a bit, it starts to sound a little bit more contemporary. And then if I bring in some of the body and the air post, so they're not feeding into the compressor, it starts to warm up and sound more and more contemporary. But you can keep this presence area going, held and hammered a bit harder with the longer release, where it's holding on and clinging much more, or shorter, and it just emphasizes that vocal range beautifully, that particular frequency area.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun.
And you can hear what I said about the release increasing as you pile on this amount. It's clearly as you back it off, you're hearing it recover quicker, whereas the squish stays on more. But whether you are letting go long, you're using less compression and letting go quicker, or more compression and holding on with more release, it always recovers enough to give that slurping accent at the edge and the breath of all those words and things. So this gives you a sort of, that's why I call this channel the slurp, right?
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
Yeah, beautiful stuff. Now if I just bring in a bit of de-esser, just to...
Mama just killed a man.
A little bit more air and then DS to compensate. Yeah, it's just starting to contemporary it up a bit by being more airy at the top and a little bit more body, you know.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against...
Okay, there's a little bit of plosive on that put, which is to my ear somewhere around 40 hertz. So let's just bring this up to, say, 50. It should kill that plosive a bit, which will get more and more the more I'm piling on this body.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against it.
Perfect, there you go. So, you know, just pile this on even more and you get more of that snatch. It holds on longer and it gets more of a squashy quality. But all the time it's emphasizing that presence frequency area where all the intelligibility of the vocals is, all the attacking of the transients, the vocal sound of the lips, the sound of the teeth, the sound of the saliva and the airiness and all that.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my
So now if we just add a bit of plate, I'll talk about the reverb a bit more, not too big.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
Beautiful. So this is like your slurp band, that's what I call it, your slurp channel, that compressor. The Fairchild is a different kettle of fish. It's fast as lightning, but it holds on a lot longer. But it has a quality, the Fairchild does, of when it holds on, because it's got a longer release. When it holds on, it still allows stuff to happen. You still get transient movement in that held release section. So this to me is more the silk, because when you pile this one on more and more, it emphasizes that frequency range, and obviously more if you pump this up, but it emphasizes frequencies where in that intelligibility upper mid area of the vocal. This one squashes a slightly different upper mid area. So if we listen to this one now, this is what I call the silk, because it's silky, it's smooth, it gets out of the way quick, even though it isn't releasing quick. It doesn't have this held quality this one does when you start to pile it on. Okay, so let's have a listen to this one, which I call the silk now.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun, but now I've gone and thrown it all.
Now if I put these about the same, and we just switch between and listen to them. Oh, hang on, they're both muted.
Against his head, pulled my trigger.
Now just listen to that pull de ma trigger, the way that pull de ma trigger, that little slap that the vocal has there, pull de ma trigger when it's being compressed. Listen to it on that one.
Against his head, pulled my trigger.
Pull de ma trigger. Now listen to it with the Fairchild, similar level.
Against his head, pulled my trigger.
Yeah, you hear how this emphasizes the treble of the pulled my you know, the edges a bit more.
His head, pulled my trigger.
And this is smoother.
His head, pulled my trigger.
Yeah, so it's sort of having an effect of squishing and scooping out a little bit those present frequencies. Now if I roll this completely flat, because it's still affecting the 1176. Let's try it like that now. So first the 1176. Just again, focus on that, the edges of that those consonants. Pull de ma trigger. Here we go.
His head pulled my trigger. Now he head pulled my trigger.
And now this one, it squishes them upper frequencies a lot more.
His head pulled my trigger. Now.
So it's a bit more silvery, this one, right? So this is like the silk. That's what I call it. And then this one, the old Universal Audio 176 valve limiting amp. This is what I call the treacle. This one's the treacle. It's like you're pouring treacle over all those different frequencies, transients moving around, and it's just making them go, you know. If you really hammer it, you start to get a lot of saturation of the transformers and the valves, and it'll actually go down there. At the bottom end, you hear it's like that.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
So it's got nice valve warmth, but if we start to really hammer it, cook it, straight away you can hear the hiss of the tape because it's hyping that. The others don't do that as much.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun. But
yeah, you get that valve saturation and that transformer saturation down the bottom end there. So this is treacly, this one. This is sort of fat and meaty, okay? But if you, the character of the 176 is if you push it and push it and push it and push it, it's here it's compressing, and the more you push it, it goes into brick wall limiting, okay? So it's kind of stay levely in that respect, I suppose.
Mama just killed a man. Put a gun again.
So right up, cooking it hard like this, it's just squishing it with that valve squish, right? But back it off a bit and it's like compressing and letting go a bit, and there's a bit more movement.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
Okay, so there you go. The slurp, the silk, the treacle, to me, that's what he got. So, you know, so you can do something like, you know, pile on that presence effect with the 1176, but back it off and give it lots of hammer. So it's holding on, but slurping away and giving you all that presence definition in the presence and definition area of the vocal. Back it right off and then have some of the silk as the main body. Let's start with this one.
Mama just killed a man.
And then we'll bring in some of that mid.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
Beautiful. Or we could go with some of this really heavy valve limiting, which squishes it and fattens it, and then blend in some of that presence area being hyped by that mid.
Mama just killed a man, Put a gun against his head. Pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
You get. Okay. So there you go. I can't go into this too much because I've done this a few times, and if I go into it really and start really talking about it, it ends up being like 40 minutes. So you know, you play with these. Now, the high pass is really good. I'll leave it as it is, but we'll just ram up this high pass right to 250, and it takes all the body bottom end out. And I've actually got the body at 12 o'clock.
Mama just killed a man.
So as I said, the beauty of this high pass is not only that it's there, which is incredibly useful, but it goes up high enough. 250 means it'll take out all that body from the vocal. And if you're trying to slot a vocal, like a rock vocal, into a really big chunking guitar mix, you ain't going to hear that bottom end anyway. So you can roll that off, get rid of any potential muddiness it might be creating, and slot it in there, right? The de-esser works. Let's roll that back. The de-esser, I'll keep it at 50 hertz, just get rid of that potential plosive on put a gun against his head. The de-esser works really, really well. If I roll this back a little, and let's roll this one back a little so it's not quite so extreme.
Mama just killed a man.
Then pile on some air. Let's roll this back even more.
Mama just killed a man. Put a gun against his head. Pulled my trigger.
And the de-esser works really well, really well. No fancy controls, but it's tuned so nicely.
Mama just killed a man. Put a gun again.
Now let's say that just killed a man again with this up.
Just killed a man.
Beautiful stuff. And at the higher center frequency, I think that's about 7.2k, and that's 6.4, something like that. Let's try the higher one on that. Just killed a man.
Mama just killed a man. Just killed a man.
So it really does the job. I'm hyping the air a lot, and the compressors, as they're being quite cooked hard, are going to emphasize any sibilance as well. It does the job really well, the de-esser. Really, really nice de-esser. Okay, now just to this what appears to be a three-band EQ, it can operate in pre or post, in which case, in pre, all three bands feed into whichever parallel compressors are operating. And post, they happen after any of the parallel compressors. But the presence control is different, regardless of whether you're in pre or post. If you cut, then it's cutting. Like in pre, if you cut, it's cutting these presence frequencies going into the comps, right? If it's post, it's cutting post the comps. But if you boost beyond 12 o'clock, you're then boosting. It always boosts, whether this is in pre or post, it always boosts that presence area into the output chain of this 1176, which allows you to do that technique where you're focusing entirely on using the 1176 and its potential styles of slurp, depending how hard you're driving it, and clinging on qualities to add as much emphasis to that presence area of vocals as you want. Having said that, it's also that this air and presence control, they're not just simple. This isn't a simple bell band EQ with a bit of a bump somewhere, as I said, between, it's somewhere between 1 and 2.5 2.7k, and it's not too vicious bump. It isn't that you're just pushing that up. And with the air, which sounds to me around 8k, it's not up something really high, like, you know, a Nevi 12k shelf. And it doesn't sound like a shelf to me. And I think it's a bell type band, subtle, not nicely wide Q, but it seems to be at around 8k to me. Now these two, when this is boosting and this is boosting, they're not. It's not that you're just boosting those frequency areas. They're boosting you can clearly hear it. There's some harmonic. It's boosting harmonically related frequencies of those areas. It's boosting the harmonics, not just a simple air or presence boost. And in that respect, when this is being boosted and this obviously just boosts, They behave very much like the Abbey Road Brilliance Pack from Softube. So these two will do what the Abbey Road Brilliance Pack does, and they're two of my favourite plugins. I use them a lot on vocals. And this entire plugin is only double the price of what you'll pay for the two Brilliance Pack plugins, which are actually on a half-price deal at the moment. Even at half price, this thing, on its current introductory deal, which I think it's still on, you're paying only just not even about double or just under double what you'd pay for the Brilliance Pack. But these two behave very much like that. They'll do what those two Brilliance Pack plugins do. So don't think this is just boosting presence and this is just boosting air. They're boosting harmonics. There's a harmonic push and saturation that's happening the more you boost them, which is extremely pleasant. Whereas the body just does what it says on the tin. It's tuned beautifully around that body area of the vocal, sort of, so 200 to 400 hertz around there. It tails off, it's sloping off nicely as it approaches four. So you never, no matter how much you boost it, you never get any nasty large cardboard box type tones. It's always just pushing more and more warmth in the body of the vocal, which is really nice. So that's what this does. So you can go for a more scoop type sound with body and air, roll back that emphasis of the consonantal edges of the vocal.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger.
Put a little bit of tape echo on just to give it a little ghost bounce back.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against
him. And now you've got a beautifully smooth and airy, more contemporary sounding vocal. Okay, and this works really, really well on R&B, neo-soul type BV groups. I'll play that in a minute on a four-part harmony going through a group bus for some neo-soul type stuff. It's beautiful for now. Okay, next, the reverb and echo. They're so well tuned. So don't think that this is a general purpose reverb and this is a general purpose echo. If you want to go for massive special effect type reverbs, you know, you're straying off beyond lexicon into your Valhalla territory, then you would use an individual plugin. And the same with echo. If you want sort of massively complex or huge echo effects, then you use something specialist for that, some type of plugin. But these are specifically tuned to work with vocals. So either of the echoes, this is tape and this is ping pong, five repeats, that's it. That's all you get. And with either the reverbs, plate or chamber, it's 2 to 2.5 seconds decay. That's it, even on the biggest size. But they're beautifully tuned to work with vocals. So the plate isn't too dark. It's they've tuned the EQ of the output of the reverb where there is no controls for it, but they have it's clearly they've tuned it, and it's just really nicely tuned to complement vocals. So the plate obviously doesn't have any reflective, you know, there's no early reflection type qualities with the plate. It's beautifully smooth, just got that right amount of plate edge, and it's not too dark. So I'll give you some plate now. Let's take the echo completely off. We'll bring back a bit of presence and back off the air a bit so it's not too scoopy.
Mama just killed.
So at the smallest size.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his.
It's like just the perfect small reverb for a vocal. It's not intrusive and you never get that horrible metallic-y, ringy, almost comb filtery edge that you get out of those smaller, you know, chain, you know, like brick bunker, you know, that horrible brick bunker or woody bunker type effect you get from often from smaller verbs. It just tunes so nice. You just get that reverb and it's gone, you know, but it's there. And I'm cooking it hard now.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger.
Yeah, nice. And there's a little bit of pre-delay before it comes back, just enough to give it so it doesn't ever start to flood the vocal, even if you're using a hell of a lot of it. Now, if we've got the sizes, it just becomes a nice and nice, bigger and bigger, nice plate. Here we go. I'll go up the sizes.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger.
2 seconds decay. That's it. Just over, maybe. Perfect. You don't want any more than that.
Mama just killed a man.
It's such a beautifully tuned reverb. Just perfect for vocals, which is what you want. That's what this is for, this plugin. B is a chamber, so you get a lot of early reflection compared, which you're not going to get from the plate. But again, in a small size, let's hear it.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
Perfect, perfect. There's that early reflection bounce going on, but it's just so quick, you know, like really, really fast, short size. But it just has the right what you want for it to lift, you know.
Mama just killed a man.
Start going up the sizes, here we go.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
Again, 2.5 seconds and it's gone. Perhaps a slightly longer decay than the plate, but not much. So they're just so well tuned, they get out of the way, they're never intrusive, even when you're piling on a lot of them. They're just beautifully tuned reverbs, which work really well with vocal. Now the delay is the same. Okay, again, this is not a delay that you're going to use for delay effects, but it's specifically tuned to work with vocals. So tape, it's dull, it's straight down the middle mono, at the subsequent repeats, of which there's only maybe 4 and it's gone, get duller and duller, and it's just beautiful. So I put it on a quarter, which is, you know, fairly long, so you'll hear it. And if I don't pile on too, you know, pile it on more and more and more, you'll hear a sort of ghosty quarter bounce back. But it's got so few repeats, it never tails off and starts getting in the way of subsequent phrases.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
5 repeats and it's gone, right? Beautiful.
Mama just killed a man.
If I put it on a short, like 16th or something, and then we get that wonderful little bounce back thing. But like down the center.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger.
Lovely stuff. Now let's put it back to quarters. If we go with the B, which is a ping pong delay, left, right, left, right, it's got about 6 repeats tops before it's gone. Again, doesn't hang around and get in the way and clutter things up. On a larger, let's keep it on a quarter. Here we go.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
There's this wonderful surroundy bouncing around of those repeats, but not too many, so it gets in the way of what's coming up. But then if we, I'll turn the top more so you can hear it. And
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against it.
Right, 5 repeats and it's gone, right? Put it on a short 16th or something, and then you get that little, you can do that sort of engineer's pre-delay trick where you take a reverb and use the pre-delay about 80 to 100 milliseconds, 110 tops, but you don't use any of the reverb. You just tap, you just dial that down to the smallest, so it's like there's not much of it, if any, audible. And you just use that pre-delay to create this little psychoacoustic bounce on the left, right, you know, ba-dum, after every smack of the snare or every phrase of the vocal or every sort of note of the guitar. And it, you dial it back in the mix, so it just, the listener hears this kind of bounce on the left, right, with everything that the vocal or the snare or the guitar, whatever, does. And it just has this effect of lifting it out. But you don't, you know, you just back it off until you can hardly hear it. But I'll put it on a bit heavier to start with. It's on a short 16th, right?
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's...
And you just bounced off, you just back it off to there. That's all you need. And then we'll blend in a bit of a... I'll go with the plate because we got some of this acting as a pre-delay. So we don't do those early reflections from the chamber maybe. So we'll go for some plate with that as well.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
Beautiful, beautiful stuff. Okay, then finally there's this mod, well, finally before we look at the output, there's this mod section, which is in effect a short and a longer chorus, but they got no feedback. Okay, so the B, when you start piling on it, and this works extremely well with smooth group BVs and something like Neo Soul, as I'll show you in a minute. It's more like you're adding the kind of flavour of an old, you know, enhancer type unit from the old days, right?
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
Yeah, you don't really perceive it as chorus, but it's more like this sort of enhancing if you don't overcook it. Let's put back some reverb and echo and hear it with that. Here we go.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
Beautiful stuff, but if we use it in the A position, it's a much wider chorus, much longer delay time. And because it has no feedback like the B, shorter, shimmery one, it in effect acts almost like a... incredibly short slapback ambient reverb, like a vocal booth or something like that, or a not too vicious coal bunker type sound, you know.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head.
Yeah, hearing that, it's just like a sort of incredibly short ambience that it, the effect it gives, because there's no feedback, you know. So yeah, fantastic stuff. It's just so well thought out, this. but then obviously it's because it's imitating or emulating Joe Chiccarelli's preferred vocal chain, and he's thought this through and experimented and worked all this out over the years, and he knows what's what and what he needs to do different things to a vocal. Okay, finally on the output there is this dry wet control, as I said, so you can blend in as much of the entire processing as you want, or use it fully wet. And then there's a drive control, which has a colour, sort of tone control as well. And this allows you to get any type of overdrive, saturation, distortion that you want, from the subtlest to full bore. So I'll crank it on, here we go, at centre zero colour, 12 o'clock.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead.
And the color working this way, it gets more toppy and taily, and this way more midi, right? So let's do that, here we go. And it's on full bore, remember.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama.
So this is great because it allows you to get anything from the most subtle saturation. And if you don't notice, if you're a beginner to all this, if you add a bit of saturation to a vocal, but particularly a rock vocal in a busy guitar mix where the vocal is fighting against a lot of layers of guitar in the same definition, presence, frequency range that which guitars tend to have with the vocal, they share those frequency ranges. Adding a little bit of saturation will lift a vocal out of a busy, heavy wall of guitars thing without it sounding like the vocals being made louder. It just has that effect. So this, one of my other favourite plugins I use a lot is the Soft Tube Saturation Knob, which is actually free. And this does what that does, but way, 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 way beyond that. So it's incredibly useful for adding subtle saturation to vocal, either to get a more retro vibe to it, because, you know, that older sort of Northern Soul, Tamla type vocal, had that driven vocal chain that was slightly saturating that gives it that character. But, you know, you can push this all the way to the most extreme distortion for, like, metal, whatever those sort of extreme genres, etc. Yeah, so I can just add a little bit of, you know, subtle drive, which spices it up a bit, let's say.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun, but now I've gone and through.
Beautiful, beautiful little addition. Fantastic stuff. It just makes it so complete. So, yeah, there you go. That's, in essence, without me going in too deep, because I could really, really go on and on about this, and really, really show you sort of much more things with the character of the compressors. But you can, you know, get it on demo and try it yourself. That's, in essence, what it does, right? There are presets, okay, and all the rest of it. And it has the usual IK Multimedia T-RackS plugin wrapper, which is not to do with your door. You run this in any door, you get this top bar across here, which has infinite undo and redo, which is a real lifesaver, plus the bank copy. So I've set this sound up, for example. I copy it, paste it to bank B. Now A and B are identical. So now I could tweak A. Let's tweak it a bit. A bit more echo on that. A little bit of the B mod. A bit more drive. A bit more of that. You know, and now I can just jump between A and B seamlessly and listen to the difference between the two and make a selection.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger.
You know, and you can have up to four of those banks and switch between them, and when you get the one you want by comparing, which is a fantastic way, obviously, to do it, rather than fiddling and then listening and then going, oh, all right, let me set it back to how it was before. You can't do that. This, you just copy whatever you've got into the next bank or which any of the other four banks. Make those little tweaks, jump between them, listen seamlessly as you audition and go, yeah, you know, that's the one. And then if you want, save as a preset. All good stuff, Shan. Do you know what I'm saying? So let's have a listen to it on some sort of contemporary neo-soul BV stuff now, because it's really, really good on that. I'll see you for that in a sec. Alrighty then, so a bit of neo-soul with a four-part BV here. There's the four tracks, there they are, and they're currently feeding to their own group bus here. Where does this EQ, there's some LA-2A emulation, some other plugins on there, including a reverb at the end, which is inserted over the channel, but there's also a little send going out to a small vocal hall, etc. Anyway, so all the vocals arrive here, and it sounds like this currently.
Let's not water it down, baby. No, no, let's just keep it 100. Yeah. Let's not water it down, baby. No, no, let's just keep it 100. Yeah.
Okay, so what I'm going to do now, so I'll take these four BV channels and I'm going to send them to this group bus here instead, which has a Joe Chiccarelli slapped across it. So we'll send those all to the JC channel, as I've labelled that auxiliary. Okay, so they're all arriving now at the Joe Chiccarelli strip here, right?
Let's not water it down, baby. No, no, let's just keep it 100.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same thing as I did in with the Freddy stuff. Let's just get everything rolled off, make it fully wet, no drive, no mod, no reverb, no echo, nothing. And I'm going to roll back the air in the body. I'm going to start with the 1176 with that presence thing. Post doesn't make any difference, but that's for the other two because I'm boosting, so it's always going to be post this 1176, that mid bump, that presence bump. So I start by getting that kind of slurping on the vocal edges going.
Let's not water it down, baby. No, no, let's just keep it 100. Yeah, 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 yeah.
press no water it down, baby.
Okay, I'm going to mute that now and go with the valve, and this I'm going to limit, really smash it. Let's solo that a minute.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
A little bit of body extra there, just a smidge, just to hear what's going on. And I'm putting some high pass at the input to roll everything below 50 hertz off.
Let's not water it down, baby.
So that's quite crushy. It's brick wall limiting now, not overly cooked. And then we'll have a bit of the silk. Let's bring some of the silk in now.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
And then finally, I'll blend in some of the 1176 with all that presence edge.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
Okay, a smidge of DS. Well, actually, let's leave that till we've put some air and body in. So now I'm warming up with some body.
Let's not water it down, baby.
Ooh. And there you go. This really shows this body warm control. There is one of the BVs that's let's just down there, and that's providing most of that D body, but this just, you can really hear the warmth coming in. I'll overcook it, but here we go.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby.
And now let's bring in some air.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
And now let's have a bit of the old de-esser to smooth out those S's.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
Really nice. Right, now just back that mid that's feeding that 1176 off a smidge.
Let's not water it down, baby.
There you go. That's great. And then I can just mess with how much silk I've got.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
This is sort of emphasizing the body a little more. Not the really deep body, but the sort of lower mid body.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
Ooh, and now let's just start in some reverb. I'll leave the mod for the moment. It's just some reverb and echo. Let's see what we get there.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
And now I'm going to give you a bit of that mod, the tight enhancer type mod. It works very nicely over these type of group BVs.
Let's not water it down, baby.
Oh, you hear how that richness is coming in now with that? It's beautiful.
Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's
let's just keep it 100. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's not water it down, baby.
Ooh.
Let's just keep it
100. Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah. Let's not water it down, baby. Let's just keep it 100.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let's go with some of the chamber instead. And this time I'm going to go with a quarter tape echo with this, going to do this just ghost thing down the middle, following it around.
Let's not water it down, baby.
No, no.
Let's just keep it
100. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Let's not water it down, baby.
No, no.
Let's just keep it 100. Let's not water it down, baby.
No, no.
Let's just keep it 100.
Yeah.
So you're hearing it now with this valve, the valve one that's doing the hard limiting. And I'll bring this in, and it's bringing in that treacly, treacliness, which is more sort of lower body. And I can back that off to thin it out.
Let's not water it down, baby.
No, no.
Let's just keep it 100.
Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah. Let's not water it down, baby.
No, no.
Let's just keep it 100.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Bloody great stuff. So yeah, fantastic on this type of vocal. Look, you know, I could play on some other stuff, but I think, you know, I've shown you enough. Get it on the demo, because the good thing about IK Multimedia's T-RackS range, like all their stuff really, is that you can get a really decent demo, like 12 days, and you can just use it. So go over and check it out. Now, I think it's on a promo deal at the moment. Let me just check that. Hang on. Okay, so I don't think it's on a deal anymore. It may have been for the first week. It's €159.99. But you can try and give it a proper demo, as I said, which is the really good thing about all their stuff. So, yeah. There it is. The Joe Chiccarelli vocal strip. Very, very cool plugin, I have to say. The only thing I will say about it is, to really get the best out of this, it requires a nicely isolated vocal. I've tried it on some material where the vocalist was like live recordings, where there's a lot of spillage from the rest of the band getting onto the vocal mic, and it doesn't work so well. But then, you know, you'll always have that problem with individual plugins or actual hardware processors, because it relies so much on the interaction between these parallel comps. It does obviously hype the spillage getting onto the mic a lot. So to get the best out of it, it does require a nicely isolated vocal recording. But it's a great product, it really is. As I say again, the presence and air controls almost behave like those Abbey Road Brilliance Pack units, the basic one that does a 2.7 or 3.5K boost or cut, and the air control does an 8K boost. These behave very similar in that they're not just a simple presence or air bump. They're definitely adding saturation, harmonic saturation, and harmonically related pleasant artifacts as you boost either of these bands. It's not just a simple mid presence or air boost. The drive control emulates, you know, any decent saturator. And so, you know, if I'm using this on a vocal, I won't need to use the soft tube saturation knob anymore, because I've got what I need built in here and things like that. It's a very, very, very clever plugin. I love the way that the each of the compressors just has a simple macro control, so you're not having to faff desperately around with too many potential parameters. It's tuned to work, you know, more, less, more, you know, more, less. And it just macros the whole thing, brings in more and backs off to less, you know. Very, very cool. In that respect, it's similar to the, what's that product IK Multimedia have? The the Lurssen mastering console, which has those overall macro controls. It's quite clever like that. So it's very immediate and quick to use. It'll get you any type of vocal sound, from biting, edgy, you know, really that you can slot into an incredibly loud and busy mixed rock vocal, which you can colour up as much as you like. It'll give you your old retro styles beautifully, beautifully, and everything contemporary, smooth as well. And you can really tune it, but the beauty of it is that everything's in one panel, so you can tune and tweak and really sculpt that vocal sound without having to have this ghastly mess of endless plug-in wrappers open all over your screen and access to all the parallel and return channels and everything. It just makes tweaking and sculpting that vocal sound so incredibly easy. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, there it is, the T-RackS Joe Chiccarelli vocal strip. I'll leave links below. By the way, that R&B artist that I just played those BVs for, that's an artist called Elliot Clinch. I'll put links to his stuff in the description below. There's also a description below link to the actual IK Multimedia page for this product. But I will emphasize again, try it out for yourself. Because the beauty of IK products is without having to have any dongles and all the rest of it, you can try their stuff and they give you a really proper demo. You can try it out really properly for at least 10 days. It's usually 12 days or something like that. And really get to use it, experiment with it, and decide if it's for you. Fantastic stuff. So, there it is. Joe Chiccarelli vocal strip. I'm very, very impressed with this. And I will see you for more videos soon. Ciao!